I still remember the first time you told me about Libby. So I get this email from Dinuk saying, you know, I met this really nice girl, you know, she's really nice, I really like her, you know, I want to tell my parents, you know. And so I was like, yeah, go ahead, you know, da da da. And Dinuk sent an email to my parents saying, you know, I met this really nice girl. Then I get a call from my parents saying, me, puta me, balanoko me, me, me. ඒ සුදු කෙල්ල පාගෙන මේ වශි වෙලා දන්නේ මේ ගිල්ල මේ ඔස්ට්‍රේලියාවට ගිල්ල බලන්න පුතා කියලා. දෙඩින් දෙඩින් සේද.
This is the foundation of their relationship. They support one another so they can both be awesome humans. They are both intelligent, motivated, and astoundingly positive people. Libby loves to take care of others. She always puts in the time and effort to maintain her relationships. She takes care of everyone in her life, and I know she will take great care of Dinuk. Dinuk is a kind, responsible man, and I know he will continue to make decisions that will lead to a happy and prosperous life for himself and their family. My hope is that your future is filled with the love, support, and sweet kisses that you have today. My dream is that one day our red-haired children will live next door to one another and have amazing adventures like we did. And soon.
Before I start the speech, I do want to say how gorgeous Libby looks tonight in a sari. You look absolutely stunning. Dinuk, you look okay. I also want to thank Mama and Papa Cox and Gunaratna Amma and Tata for doing a fantastic job raising these two young fine adults we see in front of us today.
Hi. look, ever since I met you 3.5 years ago, I always had an inkling that, you know, you were going to be the one. And I think with every passing day, a lot of your tiny little gestures that you probably didn't even realize that were things just, you know, grew on me. And it's my, you know, love for you has, you know, grown with that. Then I met your family and they were, you know, really welcoming, amazing people. And, you know, I know that your parents really had brought you up to be a beautiful young woman. And I can't wait to look forward to many, many years together with you. Love you.
Thank you.
we went to Aussie. We checked Libby out. Libby, seriously, you were awesome. You showed us Aussie. You were so caring. You took care of us, everything. And I just want to point out one more thing. Dinok turns up a week before the wedding. We went out for lunch recently, and this guy turns up and he's sitting with, you know, Terry and Bev and all of it, and he's just like, you know, Terry, I mean, this is, you know, taking into account all the weddings that are there, this is really one of the easiest, you know? And I mean, this guy's been there in Aussie, passed all the work to me, passed the ball to me. Obviously, it's been an easy wedding for you. Obviously. But seriously, we love you guys. You guys are awesome. And Libby, not only can you eat spicy food, but you can make a mean Sri Lankan meal. So we love you, and we love you both, and have an awesome wedding.
Libby and Dinok are both fiercely independent people, I feel, and they're very, very capable people, lovely people on their own. And one thing that really hits home hard is how much they make each other better when they're together. I mean, personally, I'm a little bit jealous, but it's incredible how much that they actually gel as a couple, and that's wonderful. So that's one of the things that I look at when I think about their relationship, and I go, this is actually an incredible, unique relationship, and I'm incredibly honored and privileged to be here. So thank you for listening to me, Libby and Dinok. It's been an honor to be here, honestly. Thank you very much. Thanks, girls.
Elizabeth is a wonderful person. Her dad's a terrible dancer. Dinok's a great bloke. And I'd just like to say that she has been the most amazing daughter a bloke could ever have. And that's really, really, I'm serious. She is fantastic. Now, that's it for me, but one thing, and this is serious. Everybody, serious. Libby, which cricket team are you going to go for? Australia or Sri Lanka? Right, Alice, that's it. That's it for me. Thank you very much. Thank you. Woke up in London yesterday. Found myself in the city near Piccadilly. Don't really know how I got here. I got some pictures on my phone. New names and numbers that I don't know.
Pili kata tika kata karanu. Mama godak asai singaling igena ganna. Mata singaling igena ganna godak alga kara dinuk amma we mage teacher visaka. E okkoma mama adarein istuti karanawa. Mage amma tata අපිව පොඩි කාලේ ආදරයෙන් බලාගත්තු අපිව උදව් කරා අපිව එන්කරේජ් කරා අපිව සපෝට් කරා මගේ පවුලට දිනොක්ගේ පවුලට අපි දුන සපෝට් එකට ගොඩක් ස්තුතියි
You know, early on in our relationship, I told Libby, you know, being Sri Lankan and is a very big part of me. And, you know, learning Sinhalese is actually, you know, obviously a very big part of that. And she has really dived head first and spent a lot of time and, you know, a lot of effort, committed a lot of a massive commitment to actually learn the language, and I'm really thankful for that, because you are able to share in this completely different you know, part of my life. So thank you for that. Who Libby has become now is really a testament to her parents, Bev and Terry. You guys have been amazing. You've welcomed me into your home, you welcomed me into your family, and I'm really thankful for to be able to call you guys my parents-in-law, so thank you very much. Tanya is Libby's sister. She was unable to be here, and she had a very, very little baby, but big overseas hello to her. To my family, to Amma and Tata, I mean, I'm who I am because of you guys. I've things that I've done, the things that I've achieved is because of you. The reason my two best friends are my two brothers is because of you. And the reason that we're the closest family that I know is because of you. So thank you for that.